We're very lucky that we've cultivated a fantastic relationship with people who are local to us. The relationship we have with them, it goes beyond just supplying food. Luckily for us, the people like the veg supplier, you know, the butcher especially, the dairy people, they're all within 3 miles of my business. And we use them because we want to, you know, invest in the local economy the way that they invest in us. We also want to make sure that the local providence is the key to what we do and the ingredients. But I've got to emphasise, if they weren't brilliant, we wouldn't use them. They've got to be good. It doesn't matter if they're 3 miles away. If they're no good, they won't be used. It's not just about bringing a box of produce, it's about talking about it, it's about discussing your needs and establishing a firm relationship with great people. As I say, we do tend to get a good lot of families coming to us. You know, I think that's fantastic. You know, if you go into the France and Italy and Spain and Portugal, people go out as families, and that's what we want to see. This is just a hanging teriyaki skewer of rump of beef, just simply char grilled with peppers and red onions, and with teriyaki sauce. We're simply serving that with some steamed rice and some char grilled cos lettuce. It's a bit of a nod to the more modern nature of our dishes. We're very traditional in our approach, but food trends change. These things are very fashionable. They have a great wow factor when they appear at the table. But again, it's a heavy emphasis on flavour and taste. So that it's just a great dish of great flavours again, and will please the customer on the eye and certainly on the palate. We've got some rump of beef which we've diced up. We've marinated that in some soy and chilli and honey, coriander, fennel, etc., sesame. We've marinated that meat. Then we skewer that meat onto some large skewers with some peppers and onions. Just very simply char grill that off on the griddle. We can serve that slightly pink, and then we're just going to serve that with some lovely steamed rice. As I say, we're going to just char grill a little bit of cos lettuce to finish that off. It's all about the flavours. It's about Chinese food. It's a crossover dish, really. The eclectic nature of, you know, of changing styles, shall we say. Whereas once upon a time, it was, you would get a chicken curry in a pub, which was the crossover dish. People are travelling a bit more and expecting a bit more, and they like the theatre of it as well, of course. But it's a pub dish, essentially, it's a kebab. The rump, I think, takes a little bit of cooking. You know, it's something that you can cook pink. It has, again, the rump has a little bit of chew about it, which to me is all about taste. We could put a fillet on there. Be a bit of a waste, if I'm really honest with you, to put a fillet steak on it, but you would then be talking about textures rather than tastes. That's what the fillet is. It's all about tenderness and short cooking. It's a different steak experience, if you would, whereas the rump, this one, lends itself to this dish because you can actually cook it a little bit. Make sure you cook your meat pink. You know, you've got to have beef pink, you know. Don't let anyone tell you different. But if somebody wants it well done, we would reluctantly cook it well done. You can't create great food without great ingredients. It's as black and white as that. If we've got a great product that appears at the back door, then we've got every chance of making a great meal for you. If the produce that appears at the back door is non-traceable or has been through various freezing processes, for example, where it doesn't need to, some food needs to, but if it doesn't need to, then how can you create a wonderful thing from that? You create wonderful food from wonderful ingredients.